Up on me to steal away my soul. Well, I know I won the battle when they hung Jesus on the cross. So if I won the battle, devil, I know that you have lost. I got victory. I've 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 got victory. Trouble and you don't know what to do, just lift your hands to Jesus. I know he'll see you through. He's never lost a battle and I know he never will. He won it all for you and me when he died upon that hill. I got victory. I've got victory. I've got victory. I've got victory.
Worthy that
that you should die. Please, Lord, I don't want you to. But then the Lord looked at me with those tears in his eyes and said, son, I do this for you. I stood there in silence as the Son of God began to die. I cried, Lord, ain't there something I can do? But then the Lord looked at me with love in his eyes and said, son, I do this for you. Yes, he said, son, I do this for you.
Is a long time. Everybody's welcome. This is a long time. Teresa's daughter, amen, tonight, amen, infection.
somebody somewhere else, amen. So last year, remember her, amen, tonight, amen. Remember Brother Darrell, Sister Frances, Artie, and Sister Carly Pope and her family. Remember their sister Lynn, amen, that court system, amen, will go in her favor. Amen, that they'll find favor for her, amen. Remember the two boys, Paul and Silas, amen. That God keep his hand upon them, amen. God knows the need, amen. Remember Sister Marjorie Murphy and Judy McCarty, amen. Remember them tonight, amen, out in California. Marjorie, amen, send a thing, amen, to pray for her daughter, Tina, amen. She had back problems, I think she is, amen. She asked prayer for her, amen, so remember her daughter, amen. She's, where was it at? She's in
Fort Campbell.
Fort Campbell, amen. So remember her, amen. Also remember Angela, amen, her husband. Amen. He is battling some things, amen, in his body. Amen. And only God can take care of. Amen. Pray for her. Amen. And God give her the strength. Amen. She needs. Also remember Tabitha Tran's daddy. They're saying he's got cellulitis. Amen. So remember him. Amen. That God will touch him. Amen. Got to get a hold of them. Amen. These people, amen, a lot of them, amen, needs to know the Lord. Amen. So I ask you to pray for them. Amen. Remember Nora's cousin, Paul Runyon. Tonight, amen, he needs to be saved. Amen. Also remember his brother Arthur and his brother Billy and his brother Ricky. Amen. They need to be saved. Amen. I ask you to remember them tonight. Also remember Sister Jackie's niece, Nora Nim's cousin, Cookie Simmons, amen. Sharon Moss, amen. She needs the Lord, amen. She's got something wrong with her body. She don't tell nobody, but you can tell it, amen. She needs a touch, amen, from the Lord. Brother Gary, amen, needs a touch from the Lord tonight, amen. He's having a problem with his coughing spell. Amen. And I told Sister Teresa, that's after effects of COVID. Will make you cough. Amen. So remember him tonight. Amen. In your prayers, Sister Charlotte's son. She asked if we pray, continue praying for her son. Amen. That God will get a hold of him. Amen. Straighten him out. Amen. Also remember Brother Jackie tonight. Amen. That God is being touched again. Remember Brother Roger Brown and Sister Starla, Powerhouse Pentecost, they start revival tonight. Amen. With Tyler Whitmore and Haley. Amen. So remember them tonight. Amen. That God will be with them. God will bless. Amen. I said Brother Roger a birthday thing the other day. Amen. Tell him that we love him. We miss him. Amen. So pray for them tonight. Amen. Somebody else tonight got a prayer request. Somebody else. Amen. Also remember Brother Don, Sister Kathy, and the kids. Amen. They're on their way back to Mount Sterling. Amen. Remember them tonight. Amen. God keep his hand upon them and keep them safe. Because I know Brother Don's probably wore out. Amen. So, remember them, amen. Somebody else. Let's remember our country. Amen. Remember our leaders. Amen. They need to find God. Amen. Pray for our churches around this community. Remember Sister Jean Wilson. Amen. Your prayers. Amen. God touch her body.
Remember Brother Jim Georgia.
Amen. To try to get her into the, one of the cancer hospitals down there. Yes, amen. Remember that.
Also remember Joshua Taylor's bill. He's going back to his boss. He said he needs a liver transplant, but it's not as effective as he was able to do that. So remember Mary. He said he's ready to meet the Lord, but he's going to take a liver transplant.
Amen. Somebody else. Yes, amen. Still remember Peyton. Amen. If they get a good report this week, amen, from the doctors on his kidneys. Amen. And everything, all the other tests, she said, came back good. Everything else was good. Amen. They're just waiting on the test on his kidneys. Amen. So keep praying that God will move on that. Amen. Remember, Brother Don's got to go back and have some more scans done. Amen. That God will be with him. Everything will be all right. Amen. Yeah, remember Brother Jonny and Sister Sherry and the kids. Amen. Brother Jonny, little Jonny, just went down to Alabama. Amen. They've been doing a lot of traveling. Amen. They're down there right now with Sherry, with Charity. Amen. Her blood pressure has really been doing bad. Amen. And Sherry don't want to leave her alone. Amen. So Brother Jonny, you know, remember them in prayer because they've done a lot of traveling. Amen. And God keep his hand upon them. Amen. Remember those cops, amen, that's lost their lives, amen, this week alone, amen. That, people don't even care, amen. They'll call them out on a call and then they'll shoot them, ambush them and shoot them. Brother Michael, they had a standoff here just here a few days ago, amen. Three or four of the cops got shot during the standoff. Amen. So their families, amen, they got wives and little kids, amen, that they're in the hospital in critical condition. Some of them was leaving them behind because they're killing them, losing their life. Amen. So I ask you to remember that. Remember Brother Randall and Sister Tasha. Amen. The devil's really fighting them hard. Amen. They need our prayers. Amen. Sister Vicky. Amen. They need our prayers. Amen. Brother Junior, amen. So, ask you to remember that. And Brother Ivy, amen. Supposed to start revival, I think, tonight, amen. Amen. I think Brother Ivy's in revival tonight, amen. So, remember him and his wife, amen. That God will just bless them. I seen them pictures he posted on there where they's at here last week, amen. And the kids getting saved, amen, and getting their lives changed. So remember that. Remember this service tonight. Amen. Let's just get in. Let's have church tonight. Amen. Pray for Sister Nora. Amen. She needs prayer. I need God to pray for me also. Amen. My temperature is a 96.3 and I'm freezing. I'm cold. I can't get warm. Amen. I put a blanket over me at the house and it just didn't help. Amen. But I came to church. Amen. Because I wanted to have church. Amen. I thank the Lord that he gives us the opportunity to have church. Amen. Also remember Brother Warren. Amen. I know he's up in age. Amen. He does a lot of traveling back and forth on the highways. Amen. Going back and forth to WJCR. Brother Don Powell. Amen. Prayer for him. Amen. And the radio station up there that they get it fixed where the wind and stuff damaged the roof and things. Amen. Sister Elizabeth and Brother Lorne, amen, in Texas, amen, they want to get up here to Glasgow, amen, so pray that God would open up some truck driving places for him, amen, and he can get him some loads, amen, and make some more money, amen. Sister Karen Ballard asked us to pray for her. She come out here and she said, "We just pray that God would give me jobs. God would give me jobs." And God gave her jobs, and we ain't seen her since. Amen. So, but let's pray that God would open the doors. Amen. For Brother Lauren. Amen. That God would give him some truck driving loads. Amen. That he can make some money. Amen. To make up for what he missed while he was off for surgery. Remember Nora Runyon tonight. Amen. I know she's proud of the church people that's fixed supper and took over to them. Amen. You don't know how much that blesses me to know that people is doing that. Lord be with whoever that is. But I appreciate, you know, y'all doing that. I really do. Took it on your own to do that. I appreciate that. Amen. I know Rusty does too. Amen. Also remember little Stella. Amen. I reckon she's doing better since she got home. Amen. So pray for her. Pray for Angela. Pray for Rod. Amen. That he finds Jesus. Amen. Angela said she wants him to get right with God. Amen. So ask you to remember that. Also remember Ruthie Gray. Amen. Her aunt. Her aunt's been having some heart problem issues. Amen. Ask you to remember that. Remember Jeff. He's got to go back, I think it's this week, and have another MRI done. Hopefully this time they get it done right. And he lays in there and lets them go ahead and get it done. We're going to put him under again, amen, so Carrie wants to come. And there's a little 15-year-old boy that Carrie sent us a message, amen, that laid over Cracker Barrel, and this 15-year-old boy was having a seizure right in front of Carrie. And Carrie said, Mama, pray, Mama, pray. And her and Sheila was trying to calm down his sister because her sister went into had seizures too, so they was trying to keep her calm so she wouldn't go into a seizure. And she was worried more about her brother than she was anything. Amen. So ask you to remember them. We don't know who they are, but God does.
Amen.
Amen. So remember them. Amen. In your prayers. Amen. Unspoken quest by the raising of your hands. How many are going to get in tonight?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. It's just a few.
Remember Angie Hoskins' husband.
Yes, he's battling cancer. Yes, amen. Somebody else said that somebody had stage 3 cancer. Who was that, Cassie? You told him.
Jerry Whitney said he had stage
3. Yeah, Jerry Whitney, that's it. Brother Jerry Whitney. Yes, remember the lady on TikTok this morning, amen, that gave, I think what was her name, gave her prayer request in, amen. She's been hurting in her neck and her back. Amen. So remember her. Amen. Yes, Jerry Whitney, remember him tonight, amen, when you pray. Unspoken request by raising up your hands. Pray at your seat and pray at the altar.
Thank you. Page 6, I'll come awake. Well, some bad woman with no love is all.
I once was lost in sin, but Jesus took me in. Thank you. Thank you. What could he want with someone like me? Empty and broken down on my knees, but through my sorrow, guilt, and shame,
I'm going to say something. Brother Rusty, we want to let you know, you see your prayer request. We see your prayer request, and we have special prayer for Stella at the first of service, so we are still praying for her.
Thank you.
the Lord. Amen. Couldn't get nothing, Sister Jackie. And I prayed, you know, I thought, well, Lord, maybe, you know, I fix that salad and stuff. And I say, well, Lord, what can I say? Amen. Help me. That wasn't it. Amen. 40 and verse 31. Amen. But I'm going to start reading at verse number 27. Amen. Says, why say ye thou, O Jacob, and speaketh, O Israel, my ways is high hid from the Lord, and my judgment is passed over from my God? Hast thou not known, hast thou not heard, that the everlasting God, the Lord of the Creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither weary? There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up as wings of eagles, with wings as eagles. And they shall run and not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint. Amen. I thought, as I was sitting there, God brought those scriptures to me. Brother Michael, in verse number 28, it says, hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? That the everlasting God, the Lord of the Creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that has no might, he increases their strength. Ain't you glad to know, amen, no matter what you're going through, amen, no matter, amen, how tired you are, how wore out you are, amen, God will still give you the strength that you need. Amen. You can be down, Sister Jackie, you can be out, amen, but God will still give us that strength. Amen. I thought, amen, as he was giving me those verses, amen, Sister Jackie, I like that one, Isaiah 40 and 31. Those that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Amen, but we got to wait. Amen, we can't push God. We can't rush God. We can't rush God's services. Amen. I know I like to shout. I love to dance. Amen. I love to give God praise. But sometimes we got to follow God.
Amen.
Amen. We got to let God be God. Amen. When He's God, He'll do whatever He wants to do. Amen. I believe in shouting. Amen. Because the Bible said to. Amen. David shouted before the Lord. Amen. You read all in the Bible, they shouted. Amen. I believe old Moses. Amen. When he was building the ark. Amen. Noah. Amen. When he was building the ark. I believe he shouted every day. Amen. Did he know that God said it was going to rain? And I don't believe he just whispered it to those people. And I believe they called him a hate preacher. They called him all kinds of names. They called him, "You old crazy fool. What do you think you're doing? Why aren't you building an ark?" Amen. Why do you think you... It ain't never rain. It's not going to rain.
Right.
But he said, "Those that wait, just wait. Just wait. It's coming."
Man.
He just kept on building.
Right.
Amen. He just kept on building. Amen. I know he got tired. I know he got weary, but he kept on doing it. Amen.
Right.
Because God kept giving him that strength. Amen. Kept giving him the strength. Amen. I thought about Moses. Amen. How Moses, amen, he went up to the mount. Amen. He walked up that mountain. Amen. He had to have the strength to walk up that mountain.
Amen.
Amen. He had to have the strength of God, amen, to be able to walk up that mountain. Amen, because you can't walk up a mountain, man. I'm just going to tell you. Amen, it's rough, it's hard. Amen, you got sticks in your way. You got rocks in your way. Amen, you got things you got to step over. Amen, but he had to climb up that mountain. Amen, and he had to get up there. And I know he got tired and I know he got weary. Amen, but he thought about, hey, if I just wait on the Lord, I know he's going to give me my strength. He's going to give me what I need.
Amen.
Amen, church, we got to let God give us what we need. Oh, I want to see this church overflowing. I want to see it running over with the Spirit of God.
Amen.
Brother Quentin, I want to see it come in here so strong. Amen. If you can just reach out and just touch it.
Amen.
Amen. You can just reach out and feel that anointing. Sister Ryan, I'm passing the promise. Amen. And I just visioned ourselves in there and the Spirit of God was in the place. I could just envision ourselves in there and the power of God come in the place like he said in the Bible. Amen. He said he came in, amen, like a pillar of smoke. And he sat down upon him. Brother Michael, the power of God came in so strong, the glory of God did, they couldn't even enter into the temple. Amen. Because of the glory of God. Amen. When we get into his presence, amen, we can't contain ourselves. I don't care how many times you come, amen, to the church and you ain't got in when the presence of God is here. I don't see how you can't contain yourself. Amen. I don't see how you try to hold yourself back. Amen. When the anointing of God's in the place, amen, he's trying to give you the strength to get up. Amen. He said he would quicken your mortal body.
Amen.
I'll quicken your mortal body. In other words, I'll shake it. Some people think we're crazy because we shake every once in a while. Because we dance every once in a while. Connie and Cassie lets out that big war howl every once in a while. Amen. That big scream. Amen. People think, well, them people's crazy. Well, the Bible said we're peculiar. If we ain't going to be peculiar, then why are we in church? Amen. Why do we come to church if we don't want to get peculiar? Amen. Why do we come to church? Amen. Just to come to look pretty. Amen. We come to be a worshiper. Amen. We come to be a praiser.
Yeah.
Amen. We come to give God glory.
Yeah.
Amen. When they came into the house, God's been showing me about them coming into the house. Sister Bonnie, and they polluting his house. They're tearing his sanctuaries up. Amen. And he said, I'm fixing to show them.
Right. Amen. Right.
I'm fixing to step out in the midst of them. And you know what he said? He said, behold, I'll come quickly. And I'll remove it. I'll remove it. They want to play, I can play with them. I can remove it.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. See the devil. That goes right with it. Little video thing. The Bible says it's the little things that spoils the vine.
Right,
amen. It's the little foxes.
That's
Amen. That's why a lot of people ain't got their strength like they need. Amen. They're letting them little boxes get in there. Amen. And letting it destroy what God has gave them. Amen. They're letting it get in there. Amen. And they're not waiting on the Lord. They're trying to push God. Amen. They're trying to do it on their own. Amen. You can't do it on your own. I know Sister Jackie wants them kids saved better than anything. Amen. But she cannot. Just wait on the Lord. Just wait on the Lord. Sister Bonnie wants them sisters saved so bad she's biting at the bit. Amen. But just hold on a little bit longer. Hey, listen, it took us 5 years for you. Mama, hold on just a little bit longer. Amen. They're in that prayer box. We've been praying. And I believe this year, amen, they're coming.
Amen.
Those that wait on the Lord, Brother Michael, will renew their strength. I like what he said in verse 28. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? Well, y'all heard what God can do, the goodness of God. Amen. We've heard what God's doing, the miracles.
Amen.
We've seen what God's doing out here in these colleges. Amen. We see what God's doing, amen, on these news channels. Amen. These news people are talking about Jesus. Amen. They're really talking about Jesus.
Yes,
why? Amen. Because they know time is coming to an end.
Yes.
Amen. God gives people common sense to know. Hey, church said it's coming, but we got to wait on Him. Amen. We can't tell you when He's coming. We can just tell you to get ready. He's coming. Somebody tell me, well, I've heard that all my life. Well, I have too. I'm 63-year-old. Sister Jackie's what? 67? Amen. 71. Amen. And she knows, she's heard it all her life. Jesus is coming. Almost 63. Amen. Oh, Jesus is coming. I've heard that, preacher. I've heard that. Don't tell me that. I said, well, He's coming.
Man, He is coming. Right.
I said, He can come for you tonight.
Right.
Would you be ready?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Next thing you know, but don't want to hear that. Yeah. Man, don't want to hear that. Amen. Preacher, pray for me.
Yeah.
I will. I'll pray for you. Amen, but you got to do something for yourself sometimes.
Right.
Amen, you got to get down on your knees sometimes yourself. Amen, you talk to people. Brother Michael, we can talk to people till we're blue in the face. But we can't make them pray.
Amen.
We can't not make them pray.
Amen.
But keep on witnessing. Don't ever stop witnessing. Amen, don't you ever give up. Amen, there's a woman in the Bible. Amen, she wanted her daughter healed. Amen, she wanted her daughter healed so bad. So bad. She waited on the Lord.
Amen.
She waited, Brother Michael. And her faith touched God. He said, the devil has gone out of your daughter because of your faith.
Amen.
She waited. We got to wait on Him. Amen. Those that wait. Amen. He said here, He said, have thou not known? Hast thou not heard? That the everlasting God, the Lord, the Creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not. Neither is weary. In other words, He don't worry about nothing. He don't get tired. He don't never sleep. Ain't you glad of that, that He don't never go to sleep? When we can call on Him on the midnight hour, Sister Jackie, He's right there. Amen. When children or Brother Wayne's boy, amen, gets sick at midnight, he can call on Mom and Daddy, and they can call on God, and God's right there. Amen. Sister Nora prayed for me the other night. If she called out on God for me, amen, because I needed touch from the Lord. My shoulder was hurting so bad. Amen. And she laid her hand on me. She began to pray. Amen. It don't matter. God will never leave you hanging. Amen. He's always on the line.
Amen.
He's never too busy. He's never weary. He's never went away. All you got to do is say, Lord, I need you. And He'll hear you. He said, there is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint. Hallelujah. Ain't you glad he gives us power? Ain't you glad? Amen. Listen to what he said. He said, and to them that have no might, he increases their strength. I thought about, I was watching this little boy, weightlifter, little boy, brother Mike. He probably wasn't no more than 8 years old. Brother Wayne, and he had muscles on him. And man, he'd come out there and he'd pick up them weights. And he'd pull them up and he'd curl. And he'd lift them up. Put them back down. Then I saw this other little boy, probably 3 years old, seeing Bubba doing it. And he reached and got a hold of his little dumbbell he had. And he's like, looky here, Bubba, what I can do. I got somebody to give me my. And he reached and he grabbed a hold of that little dumbbell and he just picked it up, put it up over his head like that. Where did his strength come from? Amen. God will give you that strength when you need it. But that little boy, amen, I thought, boy, look here, he's going to show his Bubba, look at what I can do. His little dumbbell was just like a, I guess, little bar with a little styrofoam weights on it or something. Sister Jackie, but he was watching them. He wanted to be like them. Bubba, can you do that? For those you picked up. Amen. Bubba would have done well to get it up the first time. Amen. But I thought about, amen, that's what God wants us to do. Amen. He will increase. Amen. He'll give us strength when we need it.
Amen.
Listen. An example. Jesus went into the garden to pray. And the Bible said that he prayed. Prayed and he came back out and he saw them laying there asleep. And he said, why? You couldn't stay awake 1 hour with me? Just 1 hour? Just sleep on. He went back in the garden. Brother Mike, when he prayed again, he came back out there, they were again. And he went back in the garden. He had to sleep on and he went back in the garden. He began to pray. Sister Jackie in the Bible said he prayed until his sweat became this great drops of blood. His strength was all gone. But God sent two of them angels down to strengthen him. To give him that strength and give him that courage that he had to have. Because he knew he was going to be having to go to the cross. He knew that he was going to be crucified. Amen. But God had to give him that strength. Had to give him something to strengthen him. We got to have that same strength. When we go through our trials. We go through our testes. When the doctor says that your wife has got the C word, guess what? Your strength is gone. Your strength is knocked, ain't it, Sister Connie? It's knocked out from under you. Just like all hope's gone. But then you pray and say, Lord, I need your strength. God, you got to help me get through this. Lord, I know that you are the healer. And I know, God, you can give me that strength. See, the devil thought, I'm going to knock you off your feet now. But see, he didn't know that God had something more planned for us. He gave us that strength, Sister Jackie, and these doors opened up. If we'd have got worried and they said, well, we ain't going to worry about it, you know, it's just something. No. Listen to what he said. He said, even the youth, shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. Why? Because they don't ask for the strength of God. You got babes in Christ that comes to church, and you tell them they're babes, and they get mad because you say they're babes. But listen, you got babes that gets their heart right with God. They're babes. Amen? And you can't just start to walk as soon as you get in church. You can't just get up and start walking because you're going to stumble, you're going to fall.
Right.
Amen. You ain't got that strength that you need. Amen. Because you're just now getting in church. And you're just now getting where you need to be established. Amen. But you can't walk because you're still stumbling. Amen. The Bible, they say, you know, the old saying is you got to walk before you crawl. You got to crawl before you walk. Amen. So we got to crawl. Amen. We got to get to the cross. We got to crawl. Amen. We got to be fed the word of God. We got to be fed. You can't take a sheep and cram a steak down its throat because it'll gag, it'll choke. Amen. They got to get their teeth gnawed out. Amen. They got to get their teeth in there. Amen. They got to get the word of God. They got to know that word of God. Amen. They got to get into it themselves. Amen. And get the nourishment that they need. Amen. And wait upon the Lord. Amen. And God will show them when it's time. Amen. For them to get off the bottom. Amen. Well, I don't want you to call. Listen, Sister Jackie is a sheep. She's a young one. She's a baby in Christ. She's growing. She's being nourished. Amen. She's being fed the word, and she's putting the word back out to them.
Amen.
She ain't just only letting it go in. She's letting it come in and go out. Amen. Why? Because that's the way you do it. Amen. She's waiting on the Lord. She's saying, Lord, whatever you want me to do, I'll do it. Wherever you want me to go, Lord, I'm going to go. I'm going to speak your word. Brother Michael. But you've got people in the church, amen, they don't want you to say, well, I'm a baby in Christ. Well, let me tell you something. Like I said, I'm almost 63 years old and I'm still learning.
Amen.
Amen. I'm still learning what the Bible says. Just like what you're getting right now. God's giving it to me. It's just coming to me out of God's mouth. Amen. I'm just telling you what he's saying. Amen. I can't tell you, amen, the times that I wanted to, Sister Jackie, just to get up and quit. I'll just be truthful with you. Everybody in here has probably thought that a time or two. What's the use? But see, God showed me this morning that we've held on through the storms, through the winds, through the rains, through the leaking roofs. Brother Wayne, we held on through patching the roofs, getting up there, me and Wayne up there patching the roofs. Sister Bonnie through painting the walls and old carpet on the floor. And we made it through it. Amen. We come through it, Sister Jackie. Amen. We went through phones, amen, on videos. Amen. I was thinking about the times. Amen. Because if I'd have gave up, amen, what would happen? What would happen? Everybody else in the church would be out of church. Because they wouldn't go to church nowhere else. No, I ain't going to go nowhere else. The devil said, no, I'll just stay home. You don't need to go nowhere else anyway. But see, God gives me that strength. Sister Jackie gave me the strength today to get up, to come this evening. I was hurting bad. I told Nora, I said, I'm hurting. I said, I don't know what's wrong. I'm having spasms in my back. You ever had spasms in your back? They're like electrical shocks going through your back. I was standing there in the kitchen. I thought, what's shocking me? It was like spasms going through my back, Sister Jackie. I never had felt that before. Like that. I felt pain, but I've never felt that before. And I thought, Lord, it's easy for me to just stay at home tonight. But I can't. Give me that strength. Not knowing that God was going to have me to talk about that tonight. Amen. We'll wait upon the Lord. Listen to what he said in verse number 31. This is my favorite verse. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up as wings, with wings as an eagle. They shall run and not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint. Amen. Lord shall is the first person experiencing the future testing. Experiencing a strong
feeling. Something strong, stout.
Brother Michael.
Mm-hmm. Expressing the future chance. This time next week, I'm still going to be talking to you.
He said, they shall mount up.
That means that they shall succeed.
They shall exceed. We shall increase. We shall exceed above and beyond what God wants. He said, we'll mount up. Mount up means we'll be mounting up. Amen. We're going higher. He's got something higher. Amen. For this church. Sister Bonnie, I'm trying to look through the spiritual eyes of it. You see, in my dream that I had the other night, I had a dream that we was in this church, and it was a big church. And I was preaching the gospel. And I was preaching what God gave me. And I seen people in the congregation. Sister Jackie, and I believe God was letting me know that it's coming. Amen. These people are coming. Amen. And I was told yesterday that they're coming. The ones that was in my dream. You say, what are you talking about, brother? God will foretell you. He'll let you know. He will show you things. Show me about Tony Dean. And I had to tell Tony Dean what God showed me about him in that dream. And I told him, I said, you got to wait on the Lord, Brother Tony. Just wait on the Lord. He said, Brother Miller, I didn't know that pastoring was going to be this hard. He said, I thought going out here being songwriter of the year and writing songs and going out and singing and things, boy, that was a good time going out doing that and, you know, going out singing and seeing people. He said, but there's a lot of people that wasn't getting blessed. They act like they were getting blessed, but really they wasn't getting blessed. But we got to wait on God. He said, well, Brother Miller, I didn't know that pastoring was going to be this hard. Way up in the morning, get a phone call. You got to wake up and answer your phone. You got them come, and then you see them leave, and they won't come back. They'll come for a couple of weeks, and then they're gone. You don't see them no more, he said. He said, I didn't know it was going to be that way, Brother Miller. I thought it was going to be just like, oh, I opened the church up. People just, I said, now you know what it feels like. Do you know what it feels like? He said, Brother Miller, you just don't know what you just said. We got to wait on God, church. And when God wants to move, we got to let Him move. Amen. The Bible says, quench not the Holy Spirit. Quench not means don't set on it. Don't grieve it. Amen. Don't grieve Him. Amen. He's not something to grieve. Amen. Just don't get in with the flow. Amen. I read about Ezekiel. Amen. And how that the fire of God, amen, would fall. The wheel and the wheel and the, amen. You read about the cherubims, amen, and how they went and took a coal off the altar and they put it on his lips and amen. And what they done, amen, it was a consuming fire. Amen. A wheel in a wheel. Amen. Brother Miller, I don't know. Have you read about it? Amen. There was a wheel. Can you imagine a wheel in a wheel? And in a turning? And the voice of God speaking? You know, people, well, Brother Miller, does God speak to you? Yeah, God will speak to you, but not all the time.
Right.
Not on a day-to-day basis. He didn't do them on a day-to-day basis.
Right.
If you read the Bible, you think, well, He was doing it on a day-to-day basis, but it wasn't. Amen. It's on further down. He would say, Son of Man, prophesy unto these children of Israel and tell them they have polluted my house. They didn't wait on me. They polluted my house. Brother Michael, we got to wait on God.
Right.
And when it's God's time, everything will start falling in place. When you're praying for your family, say, God, in your time. And it'll all start falling in place. I think, what, Craig's lost, what, 38 pounds? How much? 60. God's timing. God's place. Amen. When you let God, amen, be in control, God can do things that we can't do. But if we'll wait on Him, I like this, Sister Jackie. He said, He will renew. Renew means He'll put something new in there for you. He'll renew that old strength that you've got, and He'll give you a new strength. Amen. He'll make it new. Sister Bonnie, that old spirit that's been dried up for a while, amen. You need that good old Holy Ghost refilling, amen. He'll put a renewing in there. Some people need to get a double portion of the Holy Ghost again. They need to come back and get a double dip at the altar. Amen. And say, Lord, I need it. Amen. I need that Holy Ghost. I need it more and more every day. And listen, amen. A preacher ain't no way. He needs to get it again. Amen, too. Amen. We need to get a double dip.
Amen.
Amen. The pastors are not exempt.
Amen. Right.
They need to get a double dip.
Amen.
We go through dry spells. We go through trials. Sister Jackie, we go through things that we don't let people know about.
Help them, Lord.
Because we ain't supposed to let them know.
Amen.
Amen. We got to still stand up and preach. We still got to stand up and tell the good news.
Amen.
People say, well, Brother Miller, I don't like you because you preach on homosexuality. I don't like you because you preach on drunks. I don't like you because you preach on fornication. I don't like you because you preach on adultery. I don't like it because you preach on little Susie being little Johnny. I don't like little Johnny. You preaching on little Johnny being little Susie. Amen. I don't want to hear those things. God said, you've got to wait on Him. My strength got boosted this morning when Brother Michael told me how many people on Big O Live this morning and how our church. And I give God all the glory. I give God all the glory. Yes. The mother of the church said, if you don't like to hear that kind of preaching, then you got on the wrong TikTok video.
That's right. Wrong feed.
Amen. Or on the wrong Facebook feed. But listen, Big O Live. Amen. How many was it, Brother Michael?
3,800 plus.
3,800 plus. And that wasn't true. Amen. Hallelujah. God gets all the glory.
Amen.
God gets the glory. We don't get no glory out of it. We don't take no glory.
That's right. Amen.
That was
92%
better than all broadcasters.
92% better than all broadcasters.
Right. Amen.
Listen. Brother Darrell, Sister Francis, wait on the Lord. Sister Carly, tell Lynn to wait upon the Lord. He'll give her the strength that she needs. Brother Darrell, I don't know, but I feel like you need some strength. You're still watching, you need some strength. Read Isaiah 40 and 31. Read from 27 all the way down. Let God strengthen y'all. Listen, there's somebody tonight, God said, amen, if you just open up to me. I got a strength that you'll never ever experience in your life. Did you know there's a lot of people out there that says, well, Brother Miller, I don't understand. I don't know how to be saved, and I don't know how to get that strength. Well, let me tell you something. You've waited and you've waited, and now you're getting to hear. Amen. The Bible said all you had to do was believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ has risen from the dead, and you shall be saved. You shall be saved.
Amen.
In other words, he's going to increase. When you give your heart and life to God, he's going to give you that strength that you need. You know, a drug addict can't get off of drugs unless God gives them that strength to get off those drugs.
Right?
A prostitute can't quit prostituting until she gives her heart to God and let God give her that strength to get over it. I was thinking about Nora's cousin. All I've ever known him was cussing, 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 cussing. GD, F this, everything. It's all I ever know. He said, well, if I give my heart to the Lord, I just don't want that to come out of my mouth again. But he said, it's my vocabulary. I say it all the time. And I'm afraid I'm going to say it again. Well, let me tell you something. When you do, the Holy Ghost will tell you, hey, you can't say that. That's not right. You got to get forgiveness for that. Amen. But if that's your vocabulary, that's how you talk, and that's how you always said stuff, you've got to break yourself from those habits. Amen. But if you'll let God give you that strength that you need and wait on him. See, there's a lot of people, amen, that wants to be saved. I've heard a lot on TikTok, why we don't know how we get saved, how to be saved. But the Bible said all you had to do was call on his name. He said, those that call on my name and believe in their heart, confess with their mouth that I'm risen from the dead, he said, you shall be saved. You don't have to be beat down and brawled and all that stuff to be saved. All you've got to do is just have a broken heart. Have a contract spirit. Fall down and say, Lord, forgive me. I'm sorry. You don't have to call none of your sins out. You don't have to call no sin out. You don't have to say, God, I'm this, and God, I done that, and God, I stole this, and God, I stole that. God, I said this, and I said that. All you got to do is say, Lord, forgive me of my sins. And now wipe that plate clean as a whistle. It'll be just as shiny. Because he said, I'll take your sins, and I'll throw them as far as the east. It's from the west, Brother Michael, and he said, I won't bring them up to you ever again. I won't listen them to you. Because I forgot about them. They're gone. They're gone.
Right?
So that's how easy it is, TikTok, to be saved. That's how easy it is, big old lie, is to ask God into your heart and ask Jesus to come in. He said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. See, he's waiting for you to open the door. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. And if any man would open and let me come in, he said, I'll come in and I'll sup with him and he'll sup with me. Brother Quinn, ain't you glad that you waited on the Lord and he showed you what he wants you to do? Ain't you glad of that? See, when we wait on the Lord, he gave me that little gerbil out there, Brother Michael.
5 years.
Yeah, it took us 2 years to pray for it. And I made a statement, a stupid statement. I said, I don't even believe God can even give me a vehicle. And I said, you shouldn't have said that. I had to go across the road. I was at my daughter's house. I'd go across the road, get some. As soon as I stepped out into the road, the Holy Ghost spoke to me. He said, I can give you anything you want. If you'll wait on me. Sister Jackie. And you see what God done? It's painful. What God does. The devil told me that she wasn't going to be healed of leukemia. I mean, melanoma. But I know who healed her. Because I waited upon God. Everybody up here at that clinic would say, "What? How's your wife?" I said, "She's doing fine. God's touched her. She's been in every prayer line I can put her in. She's been in every prayer line. Would y'all pray for us? We met all kinds of people. Would y'all pray with us? Would you pray for us?" There was one man and woman up there. They were driving all the way from Eastern Kentucky to Louisville. On the other side of Eastern, almost over on Virginia line. To James Brown Cancer Center. The doctors told him that his wife, and he was kind of discouraged. But he said, "I know y'all are church people. I know y'all go to church." I said, "Yes, sir, we believe in prayer. We believe in God's going to heal. I believe in it too." He said, would y'all care to pray for my wife?" Guess what, Brother Quinn? We were there the day she got to ring that bell. She got to ring the bell. She got to go home. She got to be cancer free. Why? Because we believe in the God that we serve. And I know that God put me in a position that I had to wait on Him. Brother Michael, I would sit up every day, James Brown Cancer Center, and I'd look out that window while she was getting that infusion, that Keytruda. And I would look out at the window and I'd see them airplanes coming across. But one day I looked out one of those windows and there stood three crosses. And I know then God was going to show me everything was going to be all right. Everything was going to be all right. Why worry? Why should I fret? For that very same Jesus wants to renew your strength tonight. Amen. Stand all over the house.
To be back in your house one more time. Lord, allow us to be able to feel your presence. Lord, I know, God, that you are real. And I know that you are the healer. And I know you've been healing, Lord. You've been healing people with cancer. Lord, you've been set them free. You've been delivered them, Lord. You've been saving their souls. God, you've been bringing that gift back to you, Lord. God, I thank you for that. God, I thank you for those 3,000 and some people, Lord, that watched us mercy. Hope we go live, God. Lord, I thank you. God, I give you all the glory for it. I give you all the praise. God, just move upon them, Lord. Save their souls, God. Lord, let them call out upon you, God. God, I give you praise. I give you glory. God, I pray, God, you bless this church. You bless the people in this church. God, you bless them spiritually. God, I want you to bless them spiritually. God, I want to see that anointing flowing from them, from rest to rest. What I want to see him for. God, I thank you and I praise you, Lord. God bless their home. Bless them, Lord God. Save their children. God, save their siblings. God, I ask you right now, God, in the name of Jesus. I need your praise. I give you glory. I give you honor. God, what you do.
Thank you.
Amen. Somebody else. Y'all, from the bottom of our hearts, we love y'all. We wouldn't do nothing in no means or no ways to harm you or to hurt you in no way. We just tell you what the Word of God says. That's all we can do. Amen. And it's up to you to live it. Amen. You listening to it, now you're required to live it. Amen. You can't say, well, I didn't hear it. Amen. When you die and you go to hell and you look up and you say, Lord, why am I in this place? Lord, why am I never heard nobody preach on heaven? I've never heard nobody preach on sin. And God said, yeah, you did. You remember that night you was on TikTok and you heard that preacher preach on homosexuality. You heard that preacher preaching on drunkards and alcoholics and drug addicts and whoremongers and adulterers. You remember that night? He's going to remind you. Amen. He's going to remind you. Amen. Big old live, we appreciate y'all. He's going to remind all of y'all. Facebook Live, YouTube. Amen. We got to realize, amen, that God's going to remind you. Amen. If you're not doing that, don't worry about it. But if you are, you need to straighten up. Especially if you're going to say, if you say yourself you're a Christian. Amen. You can't do those things and be a Christian. Just because other people says they're Christians and they do it, don't mean they're Christian. Because the Bible said many, many confess with their mouth, but their heart's so far from Him. Amen. Brother Michael, he said hell enlarges her mouth daily. But he don't say nothing about heaven getting bigger. Yes. Remember Hannah. Everybody remember that tonight when you pray. Ask the Lord to touch Hannah. Amen. I believe conviction's falling. I see a lot of people don't know how to get saved, Sister Jackie. A lot of people ain't never been told. Amen. That they can get as simple to be saved. Amen. Church, listen. I'm looking for an outpouring. Can I tell you, I'm looking for an outpouring of the Holy Ghost. I'm looking for, Sister Jackie, something out of this world to hit this place wide open. And we're going to be known, we're going to be talked about. Man, we're not going to be put down, we're going to be talked about good. Man, there's something going on out there. We need to go find out what's going on. People's being healed. People's being set free and delivered. Little babies are being healed. We need to find out what's going on. It ain't what we're doing. It's what God's doing. Amen. We don't get that way. We're not got the big head because we don't do nothing without God. He's the head of this place and He'll always be the head of this place. Amen. And we just follow behind Him. We don't put Him, but we don't put ourselves before the cart. We let Him lead us. Amen. Just like tonight. I had a thought, but God didn't want me to own that thought. He went a different way. A teaching way. But we love y'all. We appreciate y'all. Like I said, we wouldn't be a stumbling block for nobody. Amen. But we just preach the truth. The good news. The gospel. That's the good news. The Word of God. The infallible Word of God, Brother Quentin, is what we preach. That's what we teach from Genesis to Revelation. We don't water it down. We don't sugarcoat it. But we love you, and that's why we preach what we have to preach, amen, to see somebody get saved. Amen. But please, please tune us back in Thursday night. You have your prayer line Tuesday night, Lord's will. Lord's will, Sister Cassie will be having her prayer line, her and Sister Bonnie, and hopefully the rest of you will have it open. Amen. But please tune us back in, amen, Thursday night, amen, at 7 o'clock. Come back expecting something good to happen. Amen. I'm looking for a good time in the Lord. I'm looking forward every time I come in here now. I'm looking for a good time in the Lord. I'm looking for somebody, amen, just to obey God. Amen. Because when one person obeys God, then the rest of the services start lining up. Amen. Lord, we appreciate y'all.
We love you.
From the bottom of our heart, from He's Alive Community Church, may God be with you this week, is our prayer. God bless you.